For billions of workers worldwide, a stable and secure job is increasingly out of their reach. Temporary, casual, part-time, and contract jobs are fast becoming the only employment on offer. With no job security, lower pay, worse conditions, and no chance to join a union and bargain collectively, precarious workers face a bleak future.
O trabalhador temporário, de acordo com a conversa que costuma ter o trabalhador com a empresa, ele não tem direito de se beneficiar de nenhum direito sagrado na lei, que é a expensão médica, não tem direito de subsídio de transporte, não são pagos subsídio de alimentação.
Ele vai sair, eu vou sair para o esforço, ele é berbeda, ada dari jaminan untuk pekerjaan dan jaminan kesehatan lebih tidak ada.
E a gente não tem os benefícios que os nossos companheiros que trabalham terceirizado aqui da Mercedes têm. E lá a gente trabalha com mais horas semanais do que aqui, né?
If you are a casual, there is no any benefits you are going to get from the company. Since you are a casual, the company is not going to take care of you.
With no chance to plan their own future, workers are driven to accept precarious work at any cost. Precarious work is increasing all over the world. While the impact may be different depending on the social and economic conditions of the country, stable employment and good jobs are being eroded at a frightening rate everywhere. Transnational companies are the main driving force behind the expansion of precarious work. Instead of employing workers directly on a permanent basis, companies are using a multitude of precarious forms of employment to evade their obligations. Their goal is cheap, flexible labor that can be brought in and dropped at will. Companies are avoiding trade unions and collective bargaining claims by keeping workers continuously on temporary contracts so that they are afraid to organize for fear of losing their jobs. They are hiding behind contractors, agencies, and labor brokers to evade their responsibilities and deny workers the chance to organize and bargain collectively. The result is that all the risks of employment are shifted from employers onto workers.
Но сами себе можете представить весь всю пагубность трехсторонних отношений, когда есть работодатель, есть псевдоработодатель и есть работник. И когда человек не знает, с кем же он имеет дело, и рабочее место у него не постоянное, профсоюзную организацию он создать не может, коллективный договор ему подписывать не с кем.
In the metal sector, in an increasing number of workplaces, precarious workers make up more than half of the total workforce. The electronics and automotive industries are currently the most affected, but precarious work is rampant across all metal industries, including steel and aerospace. George Simon is an organizer at the Australian Manufacturing Workers Union. The union has been in dispute with Foxtech, a company that assembles and packages computers solely for Hewlett-Packard. The only direct employees at Foxtech are managers and administrative staff. The rest of the workforce is hired through a labor agency.
This was certainly an extreme example, an example where you had basically an entire workforce employed on a casual arrangement through a third-party labor hire arrangement, with some of the most extreme we'd seen. Basically, workers would get a text message the night before their shift, telling them what time to come in. It could be 6 o'clock, it could be 10 o'clock. And then they turn up for their shift, not really knowing how many hours they'd been doing that day, where employees would refuse to do a shift. They'd stop getting offered any work at all. Where employees might call in sick, they'd stop being offered shifts. Where employees raised complaints or got injured at work, again, they'd stop getting offered shifts.
But even the most powerful global businesses would not have been able to do this without help. And it has come from governments and the institutions of global governance. In many countries, fierce lobbying by powerful employer bodies has led to the introduction of legislation aimed at removing barriers that might stand in the way of precarious employment. Their position is supported by global institutions such as the World Bank and the International Monetary Fund, which continue to advocate flexibilization of labor markets as the route to economic growth. Governments assist by failing to enact laws that afford strong legal protection for workers' rights or failing to enforce them where they do exist. In Korea, almost 60% of workers are precariously employed. That is to say, close to 10 million workers. Kim Hyung-woo is vice president of the Korean Metal Workers Union and used to be a precarious worker himself at Hyundai Motors.
사실 자본이 더 힘이 센 나라거든요. 그래서 법도 그렇고 사법부도 그렇고 이 정치권도 그렇고 자본가들 눈치를 많이 봐요. 눈치를 많이 보다 보니까 물론 뭐 노비를 많이 하겠죠. 그런데 노비를 하기 전에 이미 좀 종속되어 있다고 저는 판단을 하거든요. 권력이 자본에게 거기에 대고 유명 법조인들이 거의 뭐 김앤장이라고 해서 자본을 대변해서 하는 그 법률 활동을 많이 해요. 그래서 법이 우리한테 유리하다고 하더라도 그게 거의 고쳐지지 않고 거의 뭐 불법을 막 자행하는데도 그 누구도
이제 그 한국에서 비정규직을 가장 많이 창출시키는 저기 자본층을 보면 대기업이 앞장서서 비정규직을 확산시키고 양산시키기 때문에 이제 문제가 더 심각한데 이제 비정규직이 수가 이제 과반수가 넘어가고 뭐 이런 건데.
As a result of the financial crisis, about 34 million jobs have been lost since 2008, and workers in precarious employment were hit first and hardest. Permanent jobs lost are now being replaced by various forms of precarious employment. To make matters worse, worker protections are being weakened as government austerity packages cut through healthcare coverage, pensions, and unemployment benefits.
Because of the financial crisis that is currently experienced by the country, we are witnessing a number of companies closing down. Some are retrenching, have retrenched permanent employees and re-employed them under casual basis.
Los sueldos van para abajo. La clase trabajadora está pagando todo, y el ataque que se va a hacer ahora al sindicalismo, yo creo que es aniquilarlos, ¿no? Porque es el último bastión que tenemos.
문제는 지금 그 숫자 문제가 아니라 그 이 자본가들 계속해서 이 늘리려고 해요. 비중을 늘리려고 하고 우리가 봐도 줄어들 기미가 전혀 없다. 그러니까 사실은 노동을 해서 그 임금을 받고 사는 임금 노동자라고 표현되는 사람들이 거의 절대 다수가 고용이 불안하고 그런 그 불안정한 노동을 하고 있다는 것이 심각한 문제라고 저는 생각합니다.
Precarious work is bad for all workers. It creates cut-price labor that drives down wages for all. It increases the gap between rich and poor and amplifies the unfair practices that already disadvantage women, young, and migrant workers. And it is everybody's problem. Today's secure job could be tomorrow's temporary contract.
이제 그 존재가 불안정하기 때문에 조직되지 않기 때문에 우리 그 정규직 조합원들이 적극적으로 나서서 비정규직들을 비정규직들의 권리를 대변할 수 있고 또 조직하기 위한 노력들을.
Around the world, unions are mobilizing, organizing, and bargaining for better, more secure work. That means challenging the legal and political ruses that allow precarious work to flourish. It means mobilizing globally and taking union action against precarious work. Trade unions are looking into their own structures and working methods to remove barriers to the recruitment of precariously employed workers. Through organizing, unions can build solidarity between precarious and regular workers and fight to bring the whole workforce under the same collective bargaining agreements. Collective agreements that set limits on precarious employment, protect conditions, and job security for all workers.
do nosso ponto de vista, a principal política é a conquista do contrato coletivo nacional. Então nós, através da política de redes, temos buscado fazer isso, intercambiando informações entre as empresas do ponto de vista nacional e também internacional, para que possamos combater as terceirizações ou, de alguma maneira, a gente humanizar mais essas relações de trabalho.
Strong national unions and international links between them are essential to confront the forces that are driving precarious work worldwide. Global trade union action involves negotiating international framework agreements with transnational corporations to give priority to direct, ongoing employment, putting pressure on the IMF and the World Bank to change their policies that demand governments to deregulate labor markets, and pushing the ILO to take action to ensure that precarious workers' rights to join a union and bargain collectively are genuinely protected by the conventions.
If there's one thing that workers of the world, both between the North and South, must be united about, and a common message we must send to the bosses, is that this system of slavery, which belongs to the past, can no longer be the practice that must be allowed to continue in today's 21st century. Central to our demands, despite wages, is to actually ban this precarious work.
IMF affiliates are mobilizing for equal pay and conditions and to guarantee trade union rights for precarious workers. Unions seek to convert precarious jobs into permanent ones, limit the duration and the spread of temporary contracts, and protect precarious workers against dismissal. Above all, unions are fighting for precarious workers' rights to bargain collectively with their co-workers, no matter who their legal employer is, so that they have the means to improve their standard of living.
그 이전에 그 은행권의 거래라든가 그다음에 사회적인 처우 그 회사 내에서도 같은 일을 하고 있지만 그 다른 대우를 받고 있다는 그 그런 것들이 사회적인 모멸감이나 이게 괴리감이 너무 커져가지고 지금 요새도 그렇지만은 회사에 오면은 주변 사람들하고 어울리질 못합니다. 왜 그랬냐면은 그래서 아예 시도조차 하지 않는 이제 지금 현실이 되어버린 거죠. 지금은 아까도 얘기했지만 이제부터 그 저는 국민이 된 것 같기 때문에.
I know my job's secure now. My kids are a lot happy now. I'm permanent. I go to work every day. My wife is so happy because it's secure now. She's I know my job's safe. And if work gets a bit slow, that my job's still going to be here. I'm not going to be laid off because I'm casual.
We must not allow a future where corporate power and profits are built on the destruction of our security and rights. Precarious work affects us all. With the combined strength of all workers, we can reverse the tide.